In this video, we will go over yet another of many internal contradictions within dog culture. Whilst every individual dog nutter may not believe everything espoused by every other dog nutter, on a collective level, we are barraged with a slew of inconsistent and impossible assertions about the nature of dogs. Like how we will hear from dog nutters that dogs are great because they don't judge. We also hear that dogs morph into a great judge of character all of a sudden when they violently attack people at random. You lunatics need to pick one thing and stick with it, and check your comrades when they say things that contradict your assertions. However, not only do dog nutters sometimes assert that when dogs attack, it must be because they can magically detect something about your character, they specifically tell us that it is fear in particular that the dog is picking up on. And it should be noted that in the warped mind of a dog defender, whatever they say the stupid dog is picking up on serves as a justification for violence, which of course is carried out by their mindless beast. Recently, I got a particularly cancerous comment from a worthless dog simp who clearly lacks empathy for members of his own species. In point of fact, I received several. But specifically, this asshole simply wrote to tell me that all these dogs are behaving aggressively towards me because they can sense my fear. To put it in context, this was posted under the video where I explained that I hate dogs because so many of them try to aggress against me at random, when literally all I am doing is walking around. I should also make it clear as well that it is not every dog that behaves this way towards me, although plenty of them do. It is enough of them doing it to where it happens at least a couple times a week and sometimes more frequently. And I never know whose dog will be a complete piece of garbage towards me for existing or not. So I'd rather no one were allowed to own such a defective piece of crap that has this tendency. At any rate, I tried to respond several times to this piece of work and my post was deleted each time. But basically, I was trying to tell them that I am in no way afraid of the barking rats that menace me whilst I'm out, minding my own business, and simply walking from point A to point B. I also mentioned that, if this were happening on the streets instead, and these same dogs were loose whilst coming at me in the same violent manner, I assure you that the dogs would be the ones who are afraid. They would learn very quickly that they should probably be wary of attacking something that's at least 20 times their size. And all other natural animals of a comparable size naturally possess this wariness of humans. Some sources claim that small dogs tend to be aggressive because they are fearful, but the response from these nasty critters is not that of a fearful animal. Contrast that with the wild rabbits I've encountered, which also run as soon as any person approaches them. I've also interacted with ducks in many areas, and they aren't fearful of me or of humans in general. They also aren't inexplicably hostile and deranged vermin that can't tell the difference between someone minding their business and an actual cause for attack. But imagine thinking fear is a justification to assault someone at random, whether this is carried out by a nasty crap hound or anything else. I have never heard of a violent criminal getting off by stating on the stand that their victim was acting fearful and thus deserving of an attack. And if it is actually true that dogs respond to people or animals that are afraid of them by violently attacking them, then dogs are clearly bullies and assholes. And they are definitely not loving entities, because these are not the actions of a compassionate or caring entity. If you were a decent person and you met someone who was afraid or distressed, you would comfort them. You wouldn't take it as a cue to assault them or try to fight them. But the main takeaway is this. At the end of the day, our internal mental state is irrelevant. It is not a justifiable reason for one of these foul beasts to go into the psychotic fits of rage we see them displaying in response to our mere presence. If what this troll says were true, then all he is saying is that dogs get off on attacking those they perceive as weak or vulnerable. But I can assure you that I do not fear these puny, pathetic, and unbelievably ugly crap hounds. Dogs have attacked me under a number of different conditions. On occasion, I have been taken by surprise. In other words, I didn't even know a dog was there and was in a cheerful mood until I realized a dog was there. But it is immaterial. Our internal mental state is not a free pass for these vermin to do what they naturally do, and it is not a good excuse to continue to allow people to willingly possess these awful leashed goblins. If you want to support this content and see more of it, please like and subscribe. If you hate this content and want to fight for weird predator parasites, like and subscribe. Hey, yo, listen here, bro. Stay on.